Welcome guys to Panorama Tech Hub. So my name is Honorable Bonaventure Chukwudi. So you can follow me on Twitter at Bonaventure. So I'm begging you and urging you to support my YouTube channel by subscribing, press the bell icon and never miss any updates. Okay. So today we'll be building a blog app. So this particular blog app is a very big one. So it's going to actually be full stack, but the client side would be a separate tutorial from this one. So this will be like a step-by-step process, you know. So it's going to be a step-by-step process for absolute beginners and for people that want to, that are learning React, maybe they know Vue and they want to learn React, or maybe they have idea using Laravel and other frameworks, but they want to learn React. So this particular tutorial is designed in such a way that you can flow anything you want to learn. You can just come and learn it at once, and that's just it. You can decide to learn useEffect, you see, and the rest. So the first thing to do is, the first thing we're going to learn in this tutorial is to learn about component types. Learn about props, use states by building a button counter, you know. So that particular one will walk us through introduction, proper introduction to React. You see how React works and how easy it is to use it. So after that, the step two, which is a separate video, we'll learn about useEffect by building a digital clock. So that is the step two, is going to be on this, in a separate video in this same playlist. Now this is the third one. The step three is that we are going to learn about useRef, controlled and uncontrolled inputs, by building a form component that uses the two types of inputs. Now the step four, we'll make an API request and use it to build out a component and display images. We are even going to learn how to use tables too, you know. So this step five, we're going to learn about routing, you know, about routing and how to navigate from pages to pages and building our navigation bar. This step six, we're going to learn about context API and Redux. That is, this particular one would deal with state management, how to manage our state across the whole apps. Let's say you have something in an app, and instead of doing passing props and all those things, you can just use context API or Redux to share it across the app. Now, the last one is building the blog. So we are going to build the front end part. So for the back end part, which is the server side part of the blog, it's going to be on a separate tutorial, and I'm going to just make sure you subscribe and hit the notification bell so that anytime I post a new tutorial or update the playlist, you are going to get notified. So I'm going to be updating the playlist as soon as possible, but it won't be more than a week. So with that, you'll be able to flow very well. So, and that's just it. Now please subscribe. I beg again, subscribe to my YouTube channel, press the bell icon so that you never miss any update. Thank you, and make sure you follow me on Twitter at Bonarine, and that is just it. Thank you. React is a JavaScript library for building user interfaces. React is declarative, meaning that makes it's painless to create interactive user interfaces. It's component based, so that if you want to, you can divide your website or app or whatever it is, or game, into components. For example, you can have a component for about page, you can have a component for your header, you can have a footer component too, and it is very simple to learn. And to get started with React, you can actually use a CDN for it. If you notice, you can use CDN for it. So you can use CDN to learn React. So by putting this particular link in your this particular link or this particular one in your HTML page. So but it is recommended you use what they call Create React App. This Create React App. So this is a package that helps one create React App so easy. Now to get started, we are going to use this called MPS Create React App. So we're going to copy it. Now we're going to create our folder. We'll call it understand React. Yes. So I'll open this with VS Code. So this is it, understand React. So over here, you can just paste it here. So you can paste it like this. Then remove this my app. Now call it whatever name you want to call it, like block or whatever. But because I want the React application template desktop template to be in this folder and not be in a nested folder, I can just put a dot here. Now I have a npm and a yarn installed in my computer, so I can tell the computer to use npm to do it by doing this use npm like this. So I will wait while it installs. So it takes a long time to install, but very soon will be done. So once it has installed completely, you are going to have a folder structure that looks like this. So inside the public folder, you have a bunch of stuff, but this is the most important one, index.html. This is where your app lives. So this index.html, you have your title, and you have this is the main stuff. You can call it whatever name you want, but make sure you effect the change in the appropriate place. So let's just call this a blog app because we'll be building a blog. Call it blog app. Now here, you don't need to do anything to this. Now in our source folder SRC, can have the major thing here is the index.js. Now inside the index.js, you notice that this is actually taking in this app, and we are getting the root. Remember the root from the index.html. We are getting the root and passing this app to it. Now this app can just press F12 to go straight to it. This app, which is actually located here, which is this. This harbors our code. Now to actually show you what I mean, we can just start it up by hitting npm run start. npm run start, we'll wait while it opens. So it pops up in our browser with this. Let me just close up these other things. Don't need them at the moment. So we have this. Now you notice once I make any change here, for example, this, you can just call this. You can just let's just remove everything here. Let's just remove everything I have. Let's just remove everything, take everything away. And do this. Let's just have hello world. So going to this place, you notice it has been affected. So I will go up and just do this. Let's just divide the screen so that we'll be able to see our change while we work. So let's clean up this app. Let's clean up this app. I'll go over to the source. I'll remove this app.css. Delete it, app.css. Then over here, remove this. Then remove this logo. Then I will leave this. Then I will leave this too, and can just delete this logo. Then you can remove this app text if you want to. I'll just leave it like this. So I think we are good. So if I save, everything will come. So we are good. So there are different types of React components, you know. There are different types of React components. So there's this one they call class-based components. And by the way, before you follow up very well, I want you to install a package called we have to look at what you call ES7, this package called ES7 React Redux snippet. So this will help us write our code much faster. So you can just go ahead and install it. Just go ahead and install it on your machine. So I'm going to generate an app component using that package I just showed you. React component, so this React class component. So you can just call it Hello World 2. Sorry, Hello World Part 2. And just do. You see, and just refresh to see. You see, it works even though we used class based. So there are two different types of component. So there are two different types of component. There is this one, this is an app based component. There is a, this is a class based component. And even at even the app based components, even the function based component, I mean to say, are of different types. So there is this this one that looks like this. So but I prefer this particular type, this arrow function, over this. Though they are the same center, they do the same thing, but I prefer the arrow function. So I'm going to remove these class-based functions. Class-based components and this particular one, leave only the array. The arrow functions. So that is just it. So we have our app. So hello world. Sorry. So I'm going to remove everything here. Then now we are going to generate a new component using this. So this is just it. You can call it Hello World. Hello World. So we have this already. Now this particular stuff it's returning is actually called JSX. So it looks like HTML, but it is not actually HTML. It's called JSX. So you can actually return just another component. For example, let's create a component over here. let's call it hello. Just call it hello. Call it hello. Then return a div called hello world from above. Just call it this. Then instead of passing this, you can just pass in hello like this. It works. You notice, right? So it mustn't, you see, it is not actually HTML. It is called JSX. So now, if you notice, we passed a component here, but what if our component gets so big to becomes difficult for us to manage? So for that reason, we are going to create a folder inside source here. Folder, let's call it step one. Now inside this step one, we are going to have our counter.js. Now we are going to do this counter. Let's call it counter. Now in the app, we are going to have this counter. It auto imports it for us. We have counter. Now, did you know that this component can actually take in what they call props? Props are like attributes. Attributes are in HTML, such that if you want to display something, you know, you have an information that is located in this app.js, and you want the information to be shared across the whole apps or the whole folder, you can actually do it. For example, let's say we have in this step one, we have another file called sum.js, and we generated a component, let's call it sum. And in the app.js, we can just actually return this like this, and just return this. So you can return this. This is an empty, we call it fragment. It's actually react.fragment. So, but instead of just returning react.fragment, you can just return something empty open and closing tag. So inside here, if you don't do it, you get an error. Inside here, we can just pass in our counter and pass in our sum. So you notice we have sum and we have counter. Now let's say we want counter to have something. Let's say we have something declared over here. My name, something called my name. So, and my name is Bonaventure. So have this Bonaventure. So you have this, and you want your name to appear this. You want this to appear anywhere you want it to appear in these two components. Now you can do something like name. Call to just pass in my name. And now when you go to counter, you can get it as a prop. So this is called prop or properties. Props. You can get it as a prop. So you can console.log it, or you can just do this. Okay, let's just first of all console.log it. Console.log props. Save. Now open our developer tool. Control Shift I to open the developer tool. So over here, you have an object and it has name inside. So meaning that you can actually destructure these props like this. You can, I say destructure, you can actually get the props by passing props.name, right? Props.name. So in the counter, you get this Bonaventure Bonarine in the counter. Same thing can be done here. So inside the app.js, can also do this, another name, some name. You can just do something like this, or you can just call it name or whatever you want to call it, name two. Let's just call it name two, and name two is actually my name, my name. And you come over to some. Now instead of doing props, adding props and doing this props.name, there's an easy way to do it, you know. There's an easier way to do it, and that easy way is just by doing this, by destructuring it. Call it, we have a, we called it name, name two. So you bring in name two, and name two. Name two, yes. So you have it. You see? So this is how to pass props. This is how to pass props. Now passing props, you see, it's better to just do it this way than going this long process. But you can do whatever you want to do. You know, it's about preferences. Now let's get rid of the sum. Sorry, let's get rid of the sum. We don't need it. So we look at counter to build a simple counter for the main, for the moment. Build a simple counter. Bear it in mind that this project, we are going to build a blog. So this will be divided into batches. So the first step is for absolute beginners that don't know anything about React. So we are going to introduce them to React. Now, I'll get rid of the sum. Let's save. Now we have our counter, so we don't need this. You can just leave it. You can just get rid of this counter. And just get rid of this. Have remove this and the props. So okay, I can just leave it for you guys. Can just leave it for you guys to see. See, right? So I can remove it. Remove the props. We'll also use the props in the future. Use the props in the future. So you can just do this. Sorry. You can just do this. Remove this. Then remove it. Now let's focus on the counter. Now if you notice, this particular, if you notice, we are going to work only on a counter, because doing it over here is not actually very advisable. And building our component, that's how we've separated it. So for that reason, let's create a counter that increments when we click on a button and decrements, that is, goes down when, decreases when we click on another button. So say we have a button. So for that reason, we are going to just do this. Put in a div. We have our first button. Call it decrement. Then we can have our p tag. The p tag is going to show the value, and then we'll have another button. Another button is going to be the increment or plus. So this is going to be the decrement or minus. So save it, and we have, just get rid of this, and we have this increment and decrement. This looks very ugly. Let's just style it using our CSS. Now, here, notice we are importing index.css, and this index.css is located here. So that is how to import, that's how to use CSS over here. You can actually create another file, call it hey.css, and you can bring it in into, you can bring it in into the counter. Sorry, that is not it. It's in the wrong folder. So you can just go over to hey.css. So here. Now whatever you pass here, say you have called this class name instead of class, it's going to be class name, so we'll call it counter. So the counter, and we have a counter, and just make it background color. Okay, you can just make it display flex, then justify content center. So to put it in the center, let it goes to the center. Now looks like you can just give gap, you know. Yeah, you know, actually you can do gap and a flex. I just put gap of, let's say, 1 gram. It gives it gap, and let's align the, let's give it a margin top of 3 rem. So it looks like this. So you can just come over here, and just yeah, that is just it. Now this particular, so we can actually, to create the counter, we're making use of something called useState. So useState. So react.useState. So this is what they call a hook, a React hook. So you notice it passes, it gives you two stuff, the object or the value, and then a function that sets the value. So we can use it like this, the value or the state, and then the set state like this. So you can actually do this if you don't want to import, but I actually prefer importing it and using it separately. So something like this, you bring in useState like this. So instead of doing this, you can just remove, get rid of the React useState. So this, and this gets the state, and this gets sets the state. So we can just call it a value, then set value. Let the value be 0. So the value, we can actually pass it here like this. Value, it's going to be in this curly braces value. So notice it turns to 0 immediately. 0. So this button will make this button be able to set the value. So you notice if I increase this, it becomes 1. So you use this set value to set this. So let's do it. So in this body, just like, it's called an event listener. So an event listener that listens for the click on click. Notice the C. The C is in capital letter. On click, can just put in an arrow function, inside, and say set value. Set value to, let's say, the value minus. Okay. So let's save and see what happens. Sorry, value minus 1. Sorry, value minus 1. You see, it works. It works. Now let's look at the second button. On click, you can just put in an arrow function, say set value, then value plus one. So value plus one, it increases the value. Increases the value. So this is how to use useState. You don't use useState for only numbers. You can actually use it for different stuff. You can use it for different data types. You can use it for different data types, including strings. So including strings or whatever. So let's create another useState. So we call it name and the set name. So useState. So you can actually put a string, whatever here, or you can put boolean like true, or you can put even an array, even an object too, whatever. So we're going to use this. So for that reason, I'm going to create an empty fragment, React fragment, that will wrap this up and here. So we can just do this. Let's put h1, call it name. Name. Now you can put another button that's set name that's set name. So for that reason, you can just put on click, then an arrow function, then set name to Bonaventure Bonarine. So this is just it. Set name. So you can just you can also put this in the middle. Just wrap this. Let's put it in the center. So set center, text align, center. Now for the button, you can just do margin the top and the bottom. You can just do it 0 or just maybe 1 rem, then set this left and right auto. So you can also center stuff like this instead of using this. You can also do so. Let's just add the center here. Class name center. You might not see because it's not yet visible. Class name, call it center. Sorry, you can add the width. Add the width 100, view width. So it moves it to the center. Sorry, that is not it. You can make display block so it centers it. Now once you click on this, it's going to set here. Once you click on it, you're going to set name, this name, to this value here. See, understand what I mean, right? sets the name to this. So if you refresh app, it goes away. Click, it sets name, and the name gets displayed. Now you can decrement and you can increment. So congratulations, you have learned useState and you have learned the basic use of React. So we will now go back to step 2. Watch out for step 2.